Good morning, folks. So, today we are going to be having a look at bass tone, and more specifically, how the way I set up my bass tone gives me a lot of flexibility in a mix. So, generally speaking, I like to have three channels on bass, which I'll show you in a second, but three channels on bass. One is the low end, one is going to be the mid bite, and the third is going to be the grit. And through these channels, you can blend them accordingly to get 4, 5, 6 different tones, perhaps. So, let's jump into Pro Tools and I will show you. So, here we have the three bass channels that I have. This song is Enemies Within by Transients. So let's check this grit track first of all. If we just skip to somewhere in the song, so in the grit track we have this. Which just sounds disgusting, but this is the Sansamp PSA one giving this horrendous sound. And a little bit of EQ, to be honest there, the SSL console isn't actually doing a whole lot other than adding some analogness to it, if you will. Then we've got the Renaissance EQ. I use this EQ specifically for chopping out different areas that I may wish to have. So I do this because the steepness of the Q on the filters is super, super steep on the REQ, like super steep, which allows you to really hone in on what exactly it is that you're looking for. So if I were to bypass this, you would hear the full bass tone. See, perfect. Dipping out some frequencies here that just sound wretched. Hear that? Hear it? Disgusting. That's gone. Following that, nice little bit of blue phrase compression. Just taking off a little bit. Less than 3 dB. Smoothing. Again, some more frequencies that I'd discovered sounded wretched. They're now gone. And then just narrowing off a little bit more of the top just to get... See this bump here? Wretched. So that's now gone also. And that pretty much takes up the grit track. Then we've got the mid track. In this, I'm using Amplitube with the good old SVT4 Pro. So this again has been generally EQ'd. We go, knocking off some little frequencies that are ringing a little bit, and we've got the API just adding a little bit more top on it and cutting off some of that 800, and then a limiter to just kind of smooth it all out a little bit. Goodo. Then we move into the sub bass track. And that's just been limited to holy hell. Now, each of the individual components of that tone sound like arse on their own, but when you blend them all together, it sounds a hell of a lot better. Now, all this bass tone, 1, 2, 3, they're also going into this bass group. And the bass group just has just a little bit more filtering, a little bit more EQ, boosting the low end a little bit, a bit of pull tech going on, and some 3A as well. Just for a little bit more smoothing. And that goes into the bass main track where, again, it's limited. again, a little bit of analog colour, R-based boost. So what R-base does is, R-base is a harmonic frequency generator. So I have it centred around 50 hertz, so it'll produce tones on 100 hertz, 200 hertz, etc. So it thickens. The idea behind this is low end in a bass can be heard on smaller speakers, such as laptops, etc, etc. So stick a little bit of R-base on there to just give it some more oomph. Then I have a plugin called TrackSpacer, which you won't be able to see its operation unless I engage the kick drum. This is a shaping tool. So it's just helping to drop out some of the fundamental frequencies of the kick drum from the bass to give us a little bit of room. It stops them fighting, which is good. We don't want fighting. And then there's a little bit more EQ. And then Transex, which is just helping to make the first parts of the bass attack a bit more enhanced. It makes it a bit more percussive, if you will. What does that sound like in a mix? I will show you right now. Okay, so, sounds good. This section here in the middle eight is what I wanted to show you about how versatile this bass tone can be. So, as you can see from the audio tracks alone, the top grit track here is completely dropped out in the first part. So at the moment, we've only got the mid and the sub going. When the next section comes in, we are all responsible, blah blah blah, that section, the grit's going to come back in there to add a little bit more punch, and you'll hear it. So if I play from a bit before it into that section, see how it just kind of pops together a little bit. So if I solo the bass, you'll hear it. Grit coming in now. It's almost like turning a fuzz pedal on and off on a bass. But the glory of it is, you can turn that fuzz pedal on and off at will, but the bottom end stays solid and consistent, which is exactly what you want. Because if you were to apply a bass fuzz pedal to your whole bass channel, it's going to distort the low end, and I don't want that. I want the low end to be solid. I don't want harmonic distortion in the low end. I want it to affect the mids and the top. So it's easier to comp the bass into three separate tracks, and then you've got complete control of the tone. So when it builds here into this final drop, this is when you can see the bass gets bigger. Now this is done not by any magic. This is the way the player played it, which is perfect. Listen. So, in that section, never forget the 808 sub drop. Lovely. I also have this going on here. And then we've got high strings. And a cello going into it. We'll be right back. that stuff is designed to enhance the vocal, which altogether sounds like this. Love that drop. Love it. So, there you have it. That's a quick idea, a thought maybe, of how you can use the same bass track, because beneath all of this processing, this is three of the exact same bass track. I've just duplicated it. It's exactly the same. In this section, I've just cut out the bit I didn't want. I could have automated that on the channel, but I just decided to cut it out instead, so it was more of a visual representation of what it was I was looking for. So let's go from the beginning. Let's see how adding the three channels together gives punch. See? So say for instance, we wanted just low end, right? Well, I could turn the faders down, or I could just hit that instead. Now we've only got low end. Something's missing. Let's pull the mid bass back. Still not grindy enough. It needs that Korn style grind in the background. You need all three. And that's actually added to the guitars. The guitars all of a sudden sound bigger because you've got your three channels of bass and you've got, well, dual channels of guitars, and what you want is you want the mesh, you want the wall of sound. And by cutting all these, I mean, I know there's a lot of EQ on this bass, and it's cutting here and it's cutting there and little frequencies, and it's being pulled all over the place, but that is not for no reason. Not only am I shaping the sound of the bass there, but I want it to mesh with the guitars. So certain frequencies that are going to poke out on the bass are going to fight with the guitars, so they need to go. You know, obviously, your guitars are really going to take preference almost always in metal, but it doesn't mean that the bass doesn't play a very important role. It does. Because if you listen to this section of the song without bass at all, you'll realise how weak it actually sounds. I'll put the bass in. So, that's my quick video on bass. I say quick, I think we're in like 10 minutes here, easy, but you know, a quick run through on bass. I'm going to do another video today about guitar tones and how I achieve those. For anyone that's new to the channel, thanks for checking me out. I hope you enjoyed the content. Please consider liking and subscribing. Hit the bell for notifications of when I upload a new video. It's fairly sporadic, I'll warn you now, but I'm getting there with the regular stuff. I'm just a busy man. Also, I've got a brand new look website, which is nice and fancy. So if you want to check that out and get in touch with me either to say hi or to inquire about mixing work or anything like that, visit olivershillitoe.com. Nice and simple. I'll stick a link to that in the description as well. Check it out. I'm quite pleased with how it came out as far as the website goes. But for today's video and for bass, that's about it. If you've got any questions, bass players out there, if you want to hit me up, tell me I'm wrong, tell me I'm right, share ideas, hit me in the comments. Until next time, take it easy.